So to be honest with you, that was probably the quickest dip job ever, and that's okay. I used paper towels and degreaser kind of surface cleaner just to clean the surface off a little bit.
Index cards.
I will say this, if you're doing it relative when it's relatively humid, you want to get the cards down really quickly. These soak up moisture. And when you're trying to slide it down into a tire, if you don't have one that goes really deep as this one did, they kind of get real flimsy and it's no good. I got a bunch of dip from Walmart. I also got a dip trigger. I say dip trigger. This trigger shooter right here. $2-3, something like that. It's so much better than having to use your index finger and have it all cramped up just to be able to pull, you know, trigger with these two fingers like this. So much easier. Problem is, you can only get so much angle. I mean, you want to keep like maybe a 45 degree angle right there. When you're trying to get down to some nooks and crannies and whatnot, you actually end up bumping the can on the top of the rim if you're not careful. I always do this when I use spray paint. Whenever I'm done using it, I flip it upside down so the siphon tube is sucking air, and I'll press it until just nothing comes out. Valve. Stem. This time I just took something. Some paper and just curled it around. And of course I shot it with dip. And the top of the valve stem got sprayed, but that's okay because I have blue ones. And here's what I was talking about the dip and stuff away from the car. And then all of a sudden nothing's coming out. And that clears the actual nozzle at the end of it. The index cards and dip. Everything else you should pretty much have, and it peels off, so if you screw up the first time, it's alright.